Okay, so that's it.
I don't need any.
No, I don't know.
When I heard it was coming, I thought at least I should translate whatever I thought I was going to say to paper so it sounds hopefully more impressive. Okay, it's a privilege to talk to you about Claire's work tonight on such a beautiful spring evening. And I think even though spring comes around every year, it's always an occasion that fills up with excitement and hope. And isn't that what the new exhibition also symbolizes? So I hope it's also a spring exhibition for you in that way, Claire. And in talking to you, I can only relate to you my experiences as an avid collector and supporter and admirer of South African art. There's no academic background that I can bring to it, except that I've known Claire for quite a while. I've had her works in my collection over time. She has seen the collection with lots of it and stuff, and we've often discussed art, and to that extent, I guess I'm reasonably qualified to say something about her. For all of you that, might not know, Claire has been exhibiting for the and working as a painter for the last 20 years, hopefully that's not mine, no? In the last 20 years, she's exhibited it locally and abroad in the various shows. I think I've counted quickly, I think it looks like about 9 solo exhibitions, 16 group exhibitions locally and overseas. For you also don't know, I mean, Claire, born in Durban, lives in Maritzburg, but studied at the University of Stellenbosch, Machias. She's got a master's degree in fine art. She's been on postgraduate programs overseas. So she's a very well established and mature artist. You know, in looking at Claire's works over that period of time, I tried to pick up some common themes. And it just looked to me that there's always an autobiography, you know, from an element of an autobiography that runs through all Claire's work over time. As I said, she works mostly in oil. She often works in small scale. And for me, one of the special things that she contributed is the fact that she often embodies such a big concept or an idea in a very small painting and forces you to really look into detail and not to pass a painting by. Whether it's that small one next to a big one like that, I think many people will say most probably one of the most impressive works on the show. The amount of time I also know for her that she spent on some of the small works are really disproportionate to the size thereof. So I think in collecting Claire's work, I believe that ambiguity lies at the heart of all Claire's works, and whether they're still large landscapes or portraits. All the works have a promise of intimacy and a sense of disquiet to me. Claire, as I said, Claire has an extensive academic background in the arts and is very well acquainted with various art forms and movements over time. This enables her to bring an intellectual backbone to works that's often seen to be pleasant and accessible at first glance. But on closer inspection, beg a number of questions, whether it's the object, structure, or the use of colour. On the face of it, we are presented with 3 genres tonight: landscapes and intimate portraits, nudes and interiors. Jesus. Okay, Afrikaans. All 3 hierdie genres will ondersteun deur verwerk van oorstaande gehalte. En 'n ander wending van verf en kleure wat Claire oor tyd eie aan haarself gemaak het, 'n deel van haar DNA as skilder. As versamelaar wil jy altyd hê dat 'n kunstenaar moet bly groei, maar steeds herkenbaar bly. Met sy outside inslag Claire by uitstek daarin. Die werk in die groter saal waarbin ons staan, handel met bekende onderwerpe soos Claire en haar familie en vriende in water en plattelandse dorpe omring deur simbole van welee. Die werk spreek vir my van 'n vorm van nostalgie, soos Claire met die motors van ons kleintyd hier in die agtergrond, amper skaam omring deur die flamboyante lyne van die 60s. Die kinders speel in die dunne omstandighede in en by water. En Claire slag mense seens uitstekend daarin om die kykers te deelnemer aan elke scenario te maak. Dit is ons wat daar swem. Dit is ons wat die water teen ons voel. Dis ons wat onthou van kaal swem, van die sensasie van die ontwaak vir die sensuele wat kompeteer met die diepe gerusstelling van ons terugkeer na die waters waarin ons reeds voor geboorte beskerm en gekoester is. As Claire 'n naaksie doen vir iemand wat swem in 'n poel, dan voel dit vir my ek wil ook daar wees. Ek wil ook daar swem. The pictures in the smaller room are grouped as a theme, an excursion of a weekend in Paris, a visit to that most romantic of cities. Claire moves from the outside of the Platteland and from the things that we see here to an inside journey, an autobiographical journey, and she does that with seemingly constant ease. The sensuality and romanticism that are hinted to in the works we see are personalized in a city that epitomizes these sentiments. The structure of the works, the composition thereof, the positioning of the subjects, all pay homage to and communicate with masters of the genre. There is something for me of Cézanne, Freud, maybe Gustave Courbet in particular in the work, a subtext, if you will. Claire invites us into a private journey, something she has done throughout her career, but somehow for me, almost more so in this body of works than before. At the outset, it speaks of guts and maturity, a conviction, a compulsion to create and narrate even the most personal aspects of her journey. An unflinching presentation of herself attracts and potentially confronts the viewer, pushes you back from the intimacy into that. The male figures are heavy, peaceful in repose, less confrontational. Altogether, they speak of personal but essential universal experiences of love, excitement, doubt, togetherness, and loneliness. So in short, through these beautifully painted works, Claire invites us yet again to travel along on our artistic and personal journey. And as always, present enough ambiguity and mystery to enable each viewer to look and look again, to discern his or her own answer to the riddle, establish that unique special connection that makes the viewing of art such as hers so meaningful and rewarding. Thank you.